Hi, I'm Bill Kleitz. The material that I'll be covering in this podcast is out of my Digital Electronics 9th Edition textbook. I hope you find it useful.
Hi, this is Professor Kleitz, and in section 10-4, I introduced the D-latch, and specifically we talked about the 74-75 D-latch and went through the waveforms and so on. So in VHDL we can describe a D-latch also, and the function of the D-latch is to pass the binary state on its D input over to the Q output. That's called the transparent operation, while the enable line, that E line, while it's high, the D passes through to Q, and then it stores that value at Q. This is called the latch operation when the enable goes low. So while enable's low, it's latched. Okay, we can do this as a block design file, or we can do it as VHDL. So we're going to do both coming up right now. So if you need to, go back and look at section 4-4 in this textbook for the tutorial on how to use QRDIS. And assuming that you're ready to go on that, basically you set up a BDF file, and when you right-click, you say insert, and you just type in the letters latch, L-A-T-C-H, and there it is. Now it comes up with a D and an enable, and then you have the two input pins which you'll create, and I call those D0, E0, just like we did with 74-75, and then the Q output. And this is also available at the CW, the companion website, as EXE10_6. Now from here we could run a simulation directly, but first I want to show you how to do the same thing in VHDL. And the VHDL couldn't be simpler. We're already familiar with the entity group, so we have the port defines here, and the E and the D are going to be the inputs and the Q will be the output, and then we end with the same name for the file. And then the architecture area, the only thing that's new here is the process statement. Now if you put the D0, E0 in there, as VHDL is running through this loop, it'll see anytime either D changes or E changes, it executes this loop. Otherwise it just skips over it, which would be in the latch position. So if there's a change in either of these, and then it asks the question, is E equal to a 1? If it is, then take the D and move it over to Q. Isn't that exactly what we were doing with the 74-75? Sure was. End process. So now we want to do a simulation on the next figure. And here's the simulation file in figure 10-19. And by the way, these are already created for you on the companion website. And I'm going to list the E, and I've arbitrarily made a waveform that goes for 4 microseconds, then low for 4 micro, and so on. And then the D, I have a couple lows and a couple highs, and so on, just so we can exercise the functions. And remember, back in section 4.4, I mentioned the fact that if you have a BDF, block design file, and you run a simulation, if you then create a VHDL file, you have to remove the BDF file from your project before you run the simulation on the VHD file. And you'll probably remember that. We talked about that quite a bit over the previous chapters. Okay, so let's take a look at this. So while E is high, if D pops up like that and back down again, it just follows it. So Q follows D while E is high, and then Q is latched while E is low. So here's E is low, and even though D went up, it just ignored it. So it just latched into that low condition, and nothing happens until E goes back high again, and it sees this high on D, and it pops back up to a high, and then it just follows, and when D goes low, it goes low, and so on. So here's the waveforms that got created, and everything seems to work right. I ran these waveforms on my VHD file, and I also tried it on the BDF, and they both gave me the same results. So if you want to run this, you could just grab the project file from the companion website. If you grab these individual files, you can work with them, but you'd still have to create a project. But if you just grab my project file, everything will be ported in automatically, and then you could run this just to look at it. Then you could just make modifications to the VHDL file if you wanted to play around. Maybe you wanted to make the E an active low instead of an active high, and then you could just make those changes in the VHDL program and test to that. So That's it for now. So what we're going to do now is move into the next flip-flop called the D flip-flop, which is a 7474, and we'll look at the VHDL of that also. So that's it for this section.